Hello everyone. I am going to do today a demo for tooth number 36 for crown preparation for full gold crown, ADC task full gold crown. I prefer starting first with occlusal reduction, then proximal reduction, then buccal and lingual. So for occlusal reduction, we must preserve the occlusal anatomy of the tooth. And as you may know, that there is a bit difference between the 3-6 and the 3-7. 3-6 has 3 buccal cusps and 2 lingual cusps, but 3-7 has 4 cusps, nearly 4 equal cusps, 2 buccal and 2 lingual. So for in the beginning, if you want to mark the grooves or the areas that you are going to do a central, where are you going to do depth grooves in, you can mark it with a pencil, but later on you may just go with the burr directly without need for this step. But in the beginning, if you want to do that, it's okay to be a guide for you. I am using a burr, a stone, a tapered stone with round end, or a mini flat end with a tip size of 0.5 millimeters. Mostly I will do the whole preparation with only this burr. So I'm going first to do the depth grooves for the occlusal reduction. So the depth grooves we are going to put in the cusp loops, so one here and then another one here in the center, and then mesial to the distal cusp, and in also for the lingual side we'll put 3, one here, one here, and one here. And for the demo purpose, I'm not using coolant. The amount of occlusal reduction needed is 1.5 millimeters. So if you want to go with the full length of the burr, if your burr is small, it's okay, you can go with full length or either two-thirds of the length of your burr, the width of your burr. You should also do a depth groove in the central groove, because if you didn't do in the central groove will be underreduced. Then we are going to do the reduction according to our depth grooves. Put in mind that you need to preserve the anatomy of the cusps, so don't make it flat. Occlusal reduction never should be flat, so you need to go up and down with each cusp. Because of the distal cusp is near from the adjacent tooth, so it's better to put something to protect the adjacent, something like fender wedge or fender prep. And after doing the occlusal reduction, we should check with the putty whether we have the required amount of the reduction or not. Okay guys, now this is after doing the occlusal reduction. This is how it should be look like, the occlusal reduction, and then we will go for the proximal reduction. I'm going to use a Fender watch for that. You can use also Fender, sorry, I'm going to use Fender prep. You can also use Fender watch. I prefer using Fender prep for the distal and Fender wedge for the mesial to open the contacts. And remember, after each step, after each surface preparation, check with the putty for the amount of reduction. So we checked with the putty for the occlusal reduction, then we will go for the proximal reduction. I am going parallel to my Fender. My Fender prep, the band of the Fender prep. And after reducing a bit, check with the mirror indirectly if you are going in the right direction or not. So we have to check with the mirror between my steps. And always dry the field. I can see now that my Fender prep is cut, so I am going to replace it. Now it comes with a small lip. So the contact now is open. I will show you after I finish from the proximal view, but I will continue with the mesial one. I prefer for the mesial contact to use a fender wedge, because the fender prep band is very high and I cannot see the surface properly. So I prefer to use fender wedge here for the mesial. Also, we are going parallel to the band. In a slow motion. Until I break the contact. Okay, now the contact is open. I just will do first the buckle preparation, then we'll continue for the lingual preparation, then to complete the proximal. So this is the initial proximal reduction to open the contact, then I will continue after doing the buckle and lingual. So for the buckle, I prefer to first to make a line, which will be the representative of my finish line. Then after that line, I will make the depth grooves for the reduction of the gingival, first the gingival pore. Then we'll continue this, and it should be parallel to the surface while doing the reduction of this pore. Try to extend your preparation to the line angle. It's finished the gingival curve. Then we'll come to the occlusal curve to do the secondary plane or the functional cusp bevel. Do first. Also, we should do lesser groove. And also be parallel to that part of the tooth. Then after that, I will run my burr over the line angle the transition between the two planes. And I need to work on the line angles here. Then we'll do the lingual reduction. Draw a line first also, and then we'll do the depth groove. And depth groove here will be on one plane. Check my angulation from top view with the mirror. This is after the initial preparation of the proximal surface, lingual surface, and buccal surface. So now I'm going to do more proximal preparation to identify the finish line proximally, and also to work on the line angles between the surfaces.